Good afternoon, Jets Nation. Welcome to the Jujet Show. The New York Jets got their fifth win of the season yesterday, but also lost two of their best players in the effort. So let's go ahead and talk about how those injuries are going to impact the New York Jets and who their potential replacements can be. Starting off with the Elijah Vera Tucker injury, AVT is out for the rest of the year with a torn triceps injury. That's a killer for the New York Jets because Vera Tucker was our best lineman this year and was one of the best linemen in the NFL. I mean, he was making headlines for all the right reasons this year because he played three different positions at an elite level. I mean, it's super rare to find an offensive lineman that can play all positions on the offensive line, and it's extremely rare to find a lineman that can do all of those well, and the Jets have themselves a player like that in AVT. Now, good news, you know, he's coming back next season, but it just sucks to see that AVT is going to miss the remainder of the year because he was just awesome when it came to run blocking. And yesterday, we saw the effects of not having Elijah Vera Tucker. The Jets didn't run the ball as well without AVT. So it's just going to be a pain to not have our best offensive lineman for the remainder of the season. But there is a silver lining to this. First off, since he's so versatile, he wasn't playing right guard, his original position. He was filling in for George Fant at the right tackle position. So we already have a right guard who's been, you know, pretty experienced. We have Nate Herbig. He's played the past four games for the New York Jets and has played pretty good in those past four games, has done a solid job filling in for Elijah Vera Tucker, and have no doubt he's going to do a solid job for the remainder of the season. And George Fant also is going to be coming back from IR this week, or at least he's eligible to return. He might not come back, but I do think he comes back from IR this week. So the New York Jets are essentially replacing Elijah Vera Tucker with a starter from last year. So at least we're not having some bums off a random practice squad filling in for Elijah Vera Tucker. We have some starting caliber players filling in for him. They're not as good as Elijah Vera Tucker, but they're also not bad. So I do feel like this offensive line will feel the pains of not having AVT, but they're not going to be completely terrible. Now let's go ahead and talk about Breece Hall, who was basically the life of this New York Jets offense for the past 3 weeks. The passing offense hasn't been able to get going, but it wasn't an issue for the Jets because Breece Hall was completely dominating. This dude was the offensive rookie of the year favorites. Everyone was talking about Breece Hall, and now he's out for the season with a torn ACL. Now, before the draft, the New York Jets had Michael Carter as our running back number one. Now, clearly, you could tell that I had a lot of faith in Michael Carter. I had no problem with him being the New York Jets running back one this year. I wanted us to draft a running back, but I wanted us to draft a guy that could complement Michael Carter and essentially be his backup. We got a much better guy in Breece Hall. I have no complaints about the pick looking at it now, but still, I had that faith in Michael Carter being our running back one for a reason, and a ton of Jets fans have that faith in Michael Carter as well. He had a really good end to his rookie season, just like Zach Wilson. The offensive line was improved, and everyone was expecting these big things from Michael Carter. And now that Breece Hall is hurt, I feel like those expectations now could potentially be a reality for us. We might finally get to see what we saw in Michael Carter, and as a starting running back, I really do feel like he could potentially shine. I mean, week one, whenever Michael Carter was a starter, he had 100 total scrimmage yards, 60 rushing, 40 receiving, and so far this season, he has 228 rushing yards, 2 touchdowns, and also 20 catches for 151 yards. Now, that's not bad stat lines at all. And last season, he had 639 rushing yards, 2 rushing touchdowns, 36 catches, and 324 rushing yards. He's a dual threat running back, just like Breece Hall. Once again, he's not as good as Breece, but he could still be a dynamic running back that Breece Hall was for the Jets. So I don't feel like we should go out, break the bank for someone like James Robinson or Kareem Hunt, because Michael Carter can be a running back one in this league. Now, if we do trade for James Robinson or Kareem Hunt, I'm not complaining at all. Those are great players and they would definitely help out this team. I'm just saying there's no need to whenever we have the guy already in Michael Carter. Now, what I do want the New York Jets to do is find a guy who can complement Michael Carter, because he's not a guy you want to be your workhorse running back. And backing him up right now, we have Ty Johnson and Bam Knight, who I assume we upgrade from the practice squad to the active roster. But a guy I really want the New York Jets to trade for to be Michael Carter's running back two is the Ernest Johnson from the Cleveland Browns. He's currently the running back three in Cleveland right now, but last season he had 534 yards and 3 touchdowns in limited action. He got like 3 starts last season, and in all 3 of those starts he had 100 yards or more. Actually, I think in one of the starts he had 99 yards, but come on, that's basically 100. So, I mean, D'Ernest Johnson is a dude who could ball. It's just they have a crowded running back room in Cleveland, and there's no room for him to get playing time. He's a free agent after this year, so of course the New York Jets can just let him go after the season, and he wouldn't cost the New York Jets any draft picks at all. I mean, probably could get this dude for a 6th round pick, maybe even a 7th. So hopefully the New York Jets go out, trade for a running back. The deadline's November 1st, so time's kind of clicking for that. But D'Ernest Johnson definitely is a guy the New York Jets should have on their bulletin board, circled in red ink. But those are the two injuries the Jets had yesterday. Definitely killer injuries, but we can work around them, and I don't feel like they're going to completely ruin this team this year. But what do you guys think? Thoughts on the injuries, comment them down below. I'm your host, Jujet, signing off for now. See you guys later. Peace.